Greetings. Today we're going to go out to Coal Mine Canyon in northern Arizona and talk a little bit about its geology. Coal Mine Canyon is located on the Navajo Reservation about 17 miles southeast of Tuba City at the border of Hopi and the Navajo lands. And you'll see the Coal Mine Canyon chapter house right up near there. It's the turnoff to the canyon is marked by this windmill. Again, there's really not very many marked roads up on the reservation, so keep an eye out for this windmill. You'll turn off north and there's a pretty good dirt road that leads off to the end and where the canyon's at. There are picnic benches out there and such. One thing you want to remember being up on the reservation there is that even though this is a tribal park, it's really somebody's backyard. And you'll see some houses and such there. Try not to disturb them. Again, be respectful of the land and don't leave any trash and such. You could camp out there, but generally you'll need a permit from the Navajo Nation. Also, if you're going to do a lot of extensive hiking in the area, you'll want to get a permit from the Navajo Nation. It's very similar to another canyon around here called Blue Canyon, and others have posted videos on that. So you know when you get there, it's very spectacular. And we'll talk about some of the sedimentary rock geology that we see associated with this area. Now, one thing you do want to do is if you're walking around, be careful. It's steep. The rock is relatively soft and it's undercut. So rockfall is not uncommon in the area if you're down below. Also, there's a lot of exposure, and subsequently you want to be mindful of the weather, especially things like lightning. It does get cold there in the winter months, and it has snowed there. So again, you want to keep an eye on the weather. You're up nearly 6,000 feet in elevation and such. So be very mindful about hiking around and exploring this area. But I definitely encourage you to do that because you'll get to see a lot of different vistas and such. So let's get into the geology. The rocks of Coal Mine Canyon are Jurassic in age, and we know Jurassic in age from Jurassic Park. They're about 180 to about 90 million years old. However, it's part of a sequence of rocks that we see on the Colorado Plateau that we call the Grand Staircase, the oldest rocks being at the bottom of the Grand Canyon. And the Grand Canyon encompasses rocks from about 1.8 billion years old to about 250 million years old. So these rocks are a little bit younger. However, if you go to some of the other parks, like, say, Zion, well, at the very upper parts of Zion, would be contemporaneous to the age of these rocks. Now you have to realize that Zion is some 120 miles away as the crow flies from here, so there's a little bit of change in depositional sequences. Subsequently, if you're going from Zion to Bryce, you'd actually traverse this Jurassic Park of northern Arizona. Now if we take a step back and look at what North America was doing at this time, supercontinent called Pangea, where all the continents were once united about 250 million years ago, began to break up. And as it broke up, what we started to see was some little bit of mountain building on the west. Now, not the mountains that we see today, but we had the initiation of a subduction zone. And behind that, we had a big basin, and that's where we see the rocks here of this age being deposited. Subsequently, as we look at these rocks, what we see is a transgression or a moving in of a seaway. Now, what's neat about this seaway is it divided North America from west side and east side. And it was basically a shallow marine environment. And this is what the dinosaurs kind of existed with. Now, as a disclaimer, I will say that the rocks that you see in Coal Mine Canyon might be different laterally from rocks of the same age in other parts of the Colorado Plateau. You can imagine that if you were to drive, say, 60 or 70 miles from maybe your location, the environment's going to be different. Same with the rocks that are forming in those. Of course, if you're in the plains of Kansas, maybe not so. But in most other regions, yeah, you know, you're going to see what we call lateral variation. And this is what's being represented here in Coal Mine Canyon from that of some of the other national parks like Zion or Bryce, And the big kind of rock unit that we see here, it's a candy-striped rock unit, is correlative to the Carmel and Trotta formation, which is seen widely throughout, say, southern Utah. Locally, it's known here as the Cow Spring Sandstone, and it's not quite as lithified or hard like the Carmel and Trotta formations. So again, it's representing a little bit of variation as we move laterally from one place to another. Again, some of these rock units will pinch out and disappear as you move laterally. So that's one of the kind of the unique things about this area and why these rocks are so pretty. So let's let our story happen at the very beginning, which is the lowest rock units that we see here at Coal Mine Canyon. Now, we have to remember that Pangea is breaking apart, and North America is moving through the latitudes that produce some of the world's greatest deserts that we see today. Now, we have a premise in geology called uniformitarianism, which means the present is the key to the past. In the last 250 million years or so, Earth really hasn't changed that much. Yeah, the players, the animal life, and the plants may have changed a little bit, but the rates of plate tectonics and plate movement really haven't. Same with kind of the general latitudes of the Earth because of incoming solar radiation hasn't varied. So what we see here in Coal Mine Canyon is that as North America is moving through the mid-latitudes, it represented an arid time. And what we see here are things like sand dunes, and we'll see kind of what we call crossbeds in the rock units. But it was saturated with groundwater, and that's why we get the funky colors. We get the whites are associated when this was the sands were saturated with water, and the reds were when it was a little bit drier, and the iron in there actually oxidized. And the groundwater would fluctuate up and down a little bit as we started to get buckling of the plates and such. So those are the rocks at the bottom. And again, they represent what we call a sabkha environment, kind of a desert marshland. Of course, in the desert, we don't have a lot of vegetation, so we're not going to see a high organic matter. But that's going to change. So now let's look at the younger rocks of Coal Mine Canyon, and they're Cretaceous in age. And this period marks a time when we start to see the transgression or the incoming of an interior seaway that divides East and West North America. Yeah, not all oceans came in from the West. This time in Arizona, the oceans came in from the East. Now, this ocean isn't very deep. It's relatively shallow, and it's really kind of dirty and muddy because of the highlands of the continents surrounding it. And what we start to see at Coal Mine Canyon, and why the coal is there, is we're right at the shore of this, kind of like an estuary environment where we get a lot of organic material and kind of a brackish marine environment actually happening. And this is reflective of the fossils that we find in Coal Mine Canyon. For the most part, we find a lot of ostraea, which are these oyster shells, as well as a lot of marine mollusks. We also get this intermixed with a lot of plant fossils that we also do find reflecting this kind of near-shore, shallow marine type of environment. So ubiquitous to Coal Mine Canyon are the coal deposits, and coal is often formed in kind of swamp or lowland marsh type of deposits. And again, with the shallow marine estuary type of environment we see at Coal Mine Canyon, it kind of makes sense and such. Again, high organic material makes up the coal. Now, of course, it's called Coal Mine Canyon. You think, why don't they mine the coal there today? Well, the coal seems relatively thin. It's of low quality coal. Further to the east on Black Mesa, which gets its name from the coal, the seams are much thicker and of higher quality, and they do mine the coal there. After the coal was deposited, there was another sequence of rocks that were deposited upon on top of that, but we don't see it at Coal Mine Canyon. It's been lost due to erosion. Though we go to nearby areas such as Bryce Canyon and actually see these younger rocks. What had happened then is that the Colorado Plateau started to uplift. So it's kind of wild to imagine in the last 90 million years that it was once at sea level. Today it's up at about 6,000 feet, and there was about 5,000 feet of rock on top of the rock units from Coal Mine Canyon. So those have been eroded away. And it's these erosive features that gives that spectacular beauty that we see of Coal Mine Canyon. It's a lot like a lot of the national parks we see on the Colorado Plateau, such as Grand Canyon. The erosional remnants that we see at Coal Mine Canyon is not only the canyon itself, but the spires and what we call hoodoos, where we have differential erosion, a hard caprock on top of much softer rock, and this leaves this area looking very mysterious. Now, there's a lot of other stories for Coal Mine Canyon, and even though it's might not be winter when you're listening, I can't really tell you. But if you go out there, you may listen to the wind, listen to the rocks, and hear these stories. Now, if you do want to see remnants of dinosaurs, on your way to Tuba City from Highway 89, between Highway 89 and Tuba City, is a turnoff to a little community called Monavi, and there's dinosaur tracks, or you'll see signs for it if you're out looking for it. It's definitely worth the stop by. And these are actually of rocks a little bit older than Coal Mine Canyon. So yeah, Coal Mine Canyon existed during the dinosaurs. Unfortunately, we really don't see a lot of dinosaur remains there. But it's definitely worth it to go stop at the dinosaur tracks on the way to Tuba City. Well, I hope you enjoyed this adventure and got a little bit of geology associated with it. And hopefully you could make a visit up there. It's definitely worth it on a road trip. So you guys, thank you. Have a great day.